and good morning. I'm Browning Stubbs of the Christian Brothers Sports Network, and today we're going to look at some of the memories and reflections of the class of 2012, plus a special Top 10 Plays of the Year in Sports brought to you by the Christian Brothers Sports Network. Please enjoy.
Going to Christian Brothers has been a really wonderful experience for me. I just have really felt like a part of this class more than I could have felt at any other school, I think. It just feels great to finally be done with all the hard work and stuff and to be seeing it all come to fruition here at the end. And I know I'm always going to have a great respect for this school and all my fellow classmates. And I'm just excited to begin the next phase of my life, the next phase of my education. And I'll always have fond memories about here and be grateful for the things that I've learned and taken from this school.
Over these past 4 years, the Christian Brothers High School band has been the greatest thing I've ever been in. It has gotten me so involved with the school, and I'm very thankful for it. Mr. Bolton is a lifesaver in many ways, and I'm proud to be a member. I'm gonna cry when I'm leaving them.
I did Bridge Builders my junior and my senior year. Bridge Builders has been a great experience because you meet a whole bunch of different people from a lot of the different schools, and it's really good to see that everyone can come together, even if they, you know, act different or they look different and they come from different places. That's what Bridge Builders really taught me, and it, you know, helped people to just come together.
Key Club has been a great experience. I'm the vice president of the Key Club, and what the Key Club mainly tries to do is to help the community in Memphis and the greater Christian Brothers area. Key Club really is about service. It's about giving back to the community. It's been great for me. I've done over 60 service hours every year that I've been here at school. I've been at Key Club since freshman year. Key Club is a great experience, and I recommend it to anyone who wants to try to become a member of the club.
My 4 years here have been a roller coaster of emotions, both good and bad, and they were also very challenging, challenging years, and but the best years. All of us learned a lot about each other. There's no drama, there's no anything like that. Everyone knows everyone, and everyone pretty much likes everyone, so it's definitely a good place, and I'll always remember it.
Hey, my name's David Tipton. I have been a part of a band, I've been a part of chorus here, I've been a part of Brothers on Stage for the past 4 years. Chorus wasn't originally something that was very small, something I did on my off time, and now it's kind of grown to this really big class, and this thing that's going to keep growing and keep growing, and I really hope that for future students, whoever's out there, that they'll start to be interested in joining this thing, because it's going to be big. It's going to be very special. It's going to be something that you're never going to forget. Theater has been very stressful. It's been very time-consuming, but it's been very worth it. This year, I would play the role of Sweeney Todd. If you're not familiar with it, Sweeney Todd, the Demon Barber of Fleet Street. And I was put a lot of hours into it, many months, many weeks. And the show happened about 2 weeks ago. I think it went off pretty well. Anyone who's interested in doing Brothers on Stage work, go ahead and talk to Mr. Williams. He's our theater director here and our choir director. He'll be, he's very warm and welcoming, and he'll talk to anyone who's interested.
My name is Mr. Williams, and I am the director over Brothers of Faith and Brothers on Stage. And although the two entities are separate from each other, one is theater and one is men's chorus, the leadership that the seniors bring to both of these groups are invaluable. When it comes to chorus, most of the seniors have been in there for 2 years, and they bring a certain, not only just a maturation of sound, but of temperament and a desire level to be good that really infiltrates down into the younger classmen and makes them get excited about it. It's sort of the same way with Brothers on Stage. In when you're dealing with theater, you know, you always want to bring in young blood and to bring in new blood. I always want to have freshmen and sophomores coming into the shows. But without the senior leadership there, each of our shows would not rise to their full potential. And it's that combination between the leadership of the upperclassmen, our graduating seniors, combined with the freshness and with the more novice aspect of the younger students, that you get this really incredible blend of talent, which just pulls everybody higher up, and it encourages the whole group to do better. I can't imagine what the year would be like without the seniors that have invested in my programs. I love them to death. I'm going to miss them terribly. They are excellent young men, great guys, and they've been an invaluable resource to both Brothers on Stage and Brothers of Faith.
Peter, what will you miss most about CBHS?
I'm probably going to have to say Latin class with Mr. Branion and Brother Joel.
Tell us about your fencing career at CBHS.
Started as a freshman. I won the St. Michael's Cup 3 years. Sophomore, junior, and senior. We won state collectively as a team 4 times, and I won it individually 3 times.
Tell us how it felt to win the St. Michael's Cup during your senior year in front of all of the fans from CBHS and from the arch rival fans at MUS.
Oh, that's an experience you can't get twice in a lifetime. It's not like any normal fencing match. You've got just, you know, all the crowds chanting and whatnot. The adrenaline is just insane. You're not feeling anything. It's just blood pressure, basically. It was basically like a dream.
Peter Wetzel has won the St. Michael's Cup. The four-time champion wins his senior year. Peter has won the St. Michael's Cup. Congratulations.
Hey guys, my name is Dakota, and I'm going to Alaska as soon as I graduate. I'm going there for a multitude of reasons, but mainly because I want to get a better understanding of who I am, who I'm not, and who I want to be. And through that, I hope I get a better understanding of all of those things.
Glenn, you earned a scholarship. Tell us how you did it.
Well, I just put in hard work in the classroom, most importantly, then just develop my skills every day on the football field, and I was just blessed for the gift God gave me. I just used my talent to the best of my abilities and just showed out on the football field. And I was fortunate to get an offer, or at least get looked at Stetson University, so I just knew that was the right choice for me.
On Wednesday, February 1st, 5 CBHS seniors signed letters of intent to play college sports. Senior Mitchell Bennett received a scholarship to play golf at Christian Brothers University.
You're a golfer, and a lot of the guys who get scholarships play football, basketball, right, or baseball. So it's, you know, it's kind of different for someone to get a golf scholarship. So how did the recruiting process go?
Well, we were actually out. I got kind of lucky with this one. We were out at Galloway having a match, and the CBU golf team was practicing out there. And the coach came up to Coach Harris, the golf coach, and kind of started talking to him that way, and then we started talking and ended up at CBU.
Senior Chris Gardia earned a soccer scholarship to play for the University of Memphis.
Christian Brothers High School has had other athletes that have gone there. What made you want to go to Memphis?
J.J. Greer and a couple other guys that I know grew up around playing soccer with actually went there and go there now. Memphis just seemed like the right fit. So.
Senior quarterback Grant Powell received a football scholarship to play for the University of South Alabama.
How'd the recruiting process go?
It was a long one. It's a stressful process, and it's a very fun one, though. Mm-hmm. And you get to learn a couple of things, and you get to meet a bunch of different people, but it's real exciting.
How did you come to your final conclusion that South Alabama was right for you?
Well, when I went down there, it just felt like home. All the coaches were nice. I got to meet a couple of players, and just felt good going down there.
Senior defensive end Chase Robinson was awarded a football scholarship to Texas Tech.
How did the recruiting process go?
It was a long process. I've been doing it since junior year, and it's stressful. And you know, there was a lot of schools, and you know, I had my choices, luckily, and I just decided to go to Texas Tech. It's a Big 12, so I like how it's they're known to throw the ball more than run like the SEC, and so that means more pass rushing.
Senior Ben Smith received a scholarship to serve his country in the Army at West Point.
Well, next year I'm going to play baseball at the United States Military Academy.
What made you want to go to a military academy?
Well, I've wanted to go there my whole life. It's a great school academic-wise, and I've always been interested in serving my country. I know going there would put me ahead as an officer in the Army. So.
CBHS wishes the student athletes the best of luck in the future.
I have mixed feelings about the class of 2012. I've come to love all of them and will really miss them. I wish the best for them, but hate to see them go. They're an interesting bunch. If I had to give a few adjectives to describe them, I would say that they are versatile, creative, athletic, intelligent, funny, committed, and kind. This group, as of today, has applied to 963 colleges. 200 of them are distinct, including two applications to colleges outside the United States, one in England and one in Australia, and 198 additional ones in the United States. This year we've been blessed with a lot of good news, a few disappointments here and there, but overall the class has been very successful in their college admissions process. We have not quite a final count on the scholarship total, but I'm estimating it will be somewhere between $12 and $15 million. This year's class also includes 14 AP scholars, and that's based on their AP scores through last year. We won't have our new data until July, but I'm expecting that number from 14 to go up from 14 to about 22. We also have been honored by our 6 National Merit finalists and 3 National Merit commended students. This class also seemed to have a bent toward military service. We've had 4 U.S. Service Academy appointments, one to the Air Force, one to West Point, one to the Naval Academy, and one to the Merchant Marine Academy. And we've also had 4 ROTC scholarships.
How has your mother's impact in the military affected you?
Well, I mean, you know, when I was a little kid, she used to go away a lot. And, like, you know, she'd be gone on deployments for long periods of time, and kind of hurt a lot, but, you know, it also, like, helped me appreciate her as a person and, like, what she's doing for me and doing for the country. The longest tour she ever did was Iraq in 2003. I was, like, in 3rd grade, I think. And she was gone for over a year and a half. So, you know, it's like every day she just got to face that danger, and you got to wake up and just hope that she's staying safe and hearing your prayers and that God's looking out for her. And so, yeah. But.
Will she be returning anywhere?
It's not for certain yet. Right now she has a stable job at the VA downtown, so she can still get called in and she'll have to go, but it's not likely because, you know, she's got the steady job with the federal government and she's pretty well taken care of there, so hopefully not, but you never know.
Talk to us about your family in Peru and how you stay in touch with them.
Well, my grandfather and my grandmother, they're both from Peru, first generation. They moved here back in the 70s. Grandfather's side of the family, almost their whole, like, side is still over there in Lima. We keep touch with them through Facebook, you know, go Facebook. But other than that, you know, they live in, like, really, like, a very, very close community, more or less. I mean, you know, there's a couple people that live a little bit far, but, you know, for the most part, they live, you know, next to each other, and we visit them every now and then, but, yeah, so, yeah, we just keep in touch with them through Facebook, and we visit sometimes.
And will you have any family members watching the graduation online who can't make it all the way from Peru?
Yes, I have told them about it yesterday, and so, you know, it's just a matter of them getting down to the little internet cafe, because that's, in Peru, that's, you know, not everyone has internet, so you have to go down to, like, little internet cafes and hotspots, stuff like that, and so, you know, they'll probably tune in, like, the last few minutes to see at least me walk down the stage, but I also got a lot of family members in California who will be watching it, too.
Are there any other challenges that you have overcame to this point where you're graduating?
Well, I mean, my mom's a single mother, so she, you know, she worked really, really hard to provide for the family and, you know, what I have and, you know, what she's able to give for me, you know. My grandparents have also been very supportive. They've been pushing me to do my best since I was in the cradle. And you know, they just want the best for me, and they want the best life I could possibly have. And so, you know, I have to thank my family and all my other friends, you know, Browning and Chris and just all the other family friends that, you know, have really helped me get to this point.
Hey, my name is Marcus Brown. I'm a graduating senior from Christian Brothers High School, class of 2012. And my experience at CBHS was wonderful. I have no regrets. I had 4 awesome years here. Met people that, you know, I'm going to be friends with probably for the rest of my life. Just going to enjoy, like, the camaraderie we had with all the brothers. And Brother Joe, I'm going to miss him especially. You know, he taught me a lot of wisdom. And I just want to thank everybody that helped me. And I'm going to miss everybody tons. Hope I have to stay in touch with everybody in the future.
DJ, you've had a very unique medical experience. Will you tell us about it?
Sure. In August of 2010, I was diagnosed with a rare heart disorder called aortic insufficiency, which means that one side of my heart gets leaked into from the other side, and it gradually gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and eventually it would pop. So I had to get very immediate open heart surgery. And I was out for about a month or so from school, and thanks to the wonderful staff at Christian Brothers High School, I managed to get back quickly, get all my work done, and I'm almost back to normal.
And how have you persevered through that moment?
I mean, it changed a lot. I mean, I realized that life is a fragile thing and can end at any time, and I can't play contact sports at all anymore, and I can't really roughhouse at all. I'm pretty much grounded from everything, but, you know, live and let live, and you fight through it, you know.
My 4 years at CBHS have been really meaningful to me. And the reason they've been so meaningful are the guys that I've met and the guys I've grown to be brothers with here at school, because that whole community aspect of CBHS has influenced my academics and the involvement I've channeled into the other parts of my life. Because of the friendships I have here, I want to give back, and I want to be the best that I can be. And so ways that I've done that are by trying really hard and working really hard here, because the teachers demand it of you, and your friends demand it of you, because they know that you can be your best if they challenge you to be their best, and they do that every single day. And so that is one reason I'm really honored to be co-salutatorian, because it's not all me. My friends really helped me through the 4 years at CBHS and really challenged me to keep working and to always work. And I wouldn't be co-salutatorian if I didn't have that drive. And I guess partially related to that is the search program that I'm involved with. And that, like at Christian Brothers, we have something we call the search family. And everyone who goes through search is part of the search family. And what that family is it's a group of people who can depend on each other no matter what, and who know that they're always loved by that family wherever they go and wherever they are, which is something like here at CBHS. It's a different kind of love at CBHS. It's love between brothers, but it's just as meaningful. And so search has really helped a lot of people by giving them kind of a rock to fall back on and a strength to get them through their daily lives when things get really hard.
So I entered a competition last year. It was from a Jewish humanitarian organization in New York. It's called B'nai B'rith, and the competition was to write and illustrate a children's book that conveyed diversity and the importance of it. So I entered it, and I wrote and illustrated a book called The Peanut Butter Bee, and it's about a a honeybee that makes peanut butter instead of honey. And at first, she's ostracized, but then she's later accepted. So it was published, and it was distributed to local libraries and elementary schools. And that was about last summer, and I didn't really plan on doing another children's book until the beginning of this semester. I had a really good idea, and I was kind of interested in it. So I'm almost done with my next book now, and it's called The Coolest Dog Ever, and it's about a boy who goes to an animal shelter to adopt a dog, and he says that he wants the coolest dog ever, and the dog that he adopts really feels the pressure to be cool, so he goes about it in all the wrong ways. He rides a motorcycle, he throws parties late at night, he plays the drums late at night, he texts all of his friends, and he's really just pretty much a nuisance to the boy, but you'll have to buy the book to, I guess, figure out how things work out. But I'm actually up here right now at school working on it, finishing it, and hopefully it'll get published and it'll be out later this year.
As class president, you made many senior memories. What are you going to miss most about class of 2012?
Well, I mean, class of 2012, it has all my best friends. You know, every friend that I can think of is in this class, and I've really loved it while I'm here. And you know, I'll be in Memphis next year. I'm going to Rhodes, and I still hope that we can all keep in contact. They'll be going all over, well, pretty much just the South, but hopefully when they come back to Memphis, we can all get together and, you know, still have a good time. But I'm pretty confident that our class will always stay together, and I'm really looking forward to our 10-year reunion.
Now here's what you've actually all been waiting for. The top 10 plays of the 2011-2012 Christian Brothers Sports Year. Brought to you by the Christian Brothers Sports Network.
Oh yeah, no doubt they're in great position. As Warren,
that ought to do it
long,
right there. That's going to score two runs.
It's going to bring it right down the middle. And Lawrence has got a slide here. And he's
safe.
He's out.
Oh.
It was a very, very close call there, but nonetheless, great hit there by Tyler Lawrence to bring in two, and that gets Christian Brothers the first lead of the game at 2-0.
At the Staver takes a snap, throws. Oh, that ball almost caught. Oh, he fumbled it. That's picked up. He's at the 15, 20, 15, 10, brought down at the 5-yard line.
Pass is going to be deflected by Ochani. He beats him to the cut, lays it up, and it's good. Nice play to read the steal and get the layup, James. It's Costa back. On
that
deep.
One's dangerous looking. It's in. It's there for
he's
Connor.
He's got a shot.
Goal!
There's Coach Lima jumping for joy. Woo! Boer is going to go to the basket on Nichols. I don't know about this. Look at that elevation by Boer. He went up and under on Nichols, and that's got to be a highlight of the year so far.
As the punt, and Christian Brothers coming after it. Oh, and it's blocked. He blocked it. He picks it up. Stone, touchdown, Christian Brothers. Off the blocked punt by Peyton Stone.
In their road purple jerseys.
Guardia shot. Gonna launch it. Goal!
What a shot.
An absolute rocket from Chris Guardia.
Marcus Dean's not complaining. He's going to take it the length of the court for Ochani.
Oh!
Dean has it. Gets into the corner. Shot's taken.
is good.
Back-to-back threes for Adam Okolachani. And Browning, I think Christian Brothers has a little bit of a luxury in having...
He's got the hot hand! Okolachani with his third three-footer. DJ wants to set it up. Got Okolachani with the three.
Oh!
I'm loving it, Lawrence. I'm loving Christian Brothers basketball tonight.
Takes a snap, looks, he's pressured, he's going to run with it, he breaks free, he's at the 50, 45, 40, 30, 20, 5, touchdown, Christian Brothers! What a run by Grant Powell!
It's say yeah! Okolachani dribbles it up quick for the Brothers. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, he takes the shot, no good. But Mitchell with a fine shot! It's good! Mitchell! The Christian Brothers broke away and defeated Brian Crest!
On behalf of the graduating class of 2012, I'd like to thank you all for watching the senior tribute video, and we'd also like to thank you for the opportunity to participate in the first year of the Christian Brothers Sports Network, and we look forward to its continued success in the years to come.